Pakistan has always tried to revive the issue of Khalistan, a separatist movement that is long dead. Through various means and strategies, Islamabad tries to instigate Sikh youth in India and abroad with the objective of spoiling their future. However, the movement has gotten nowhere despite Pakistani support. Take a look.
The support for Khalistan in India has sunk very low, but the militant groups like the Khalistan Liberation Force and Sikhs for Justice have been pushing their agenda hard through various platforms with the help of the Pakistan's ISI. Notorious ISI is making every possible attempt to bolster Khalistan groups in different countries across the globe. Pak-backed Khalistan ideologue Gurpatwant Singh Pannu of banned outfit Sikhs for Justice is continuously attempting to disturb Punjab's peace, stability and communal harmony. He often uploads incendiary videos to his YouTube channel in order to incite Sikhs in Punjab to oppose India. Recently, Pannu released yet another video in which he threatened Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi and tried to instigate common youth. The pro-Khalistan agenda for a separate homeland has no takers in Punjab. But the cause still survives in Pakistan, where jihadist groups have made common cause with Sikh separatists like Pannu against their shared enemy, India.
After creation of Pakistan after 1947, there were so many sacred places of Sikhs in Pakistan. The sacred places of Sikhs are called Gurdwara Sahib. The three most sacred places of Sikhs still are in Pakistan. Nankana Sahib, the birthplace of Sikh religion's creator. Kartarpur Sahib. Panja Sahib. Now those who want to create Khalistan, a separate Sikh state, they ignore these three sacred places of Sikhs which are in Pakistan, which shows their intention that they are fulfilling Pakistan's agenda.
Islamabad's role in supporting the Khalistan movement is a direct consequence of 1971 breakup of Pakistan. When Bangladesh was formed out of East Pakistan with the help of the Indian Armed Forces. Following 1971 war, the only thing Pakistan wanted was revenge, and more specifically, bleeding India with 1,000 cuts. Thus, post-1971, Pakistan's policies and strategical measures underwent transition and became entirely dedicated to hurt India along with the religious, political, and ethnic lines. In this way, the foundation of the Khalistan movement was laid. The ethnic cleansing, forced conversions, targeted attacks on the Gurdwaras have reduced the Sikhs, Hindus, and Christians into a small fraction of community in Pakistan. Yet Pakistan assumes to be the champion of the Khalistani causes and support the Khalistan militancy.
General Yahya Khan and Bhutto wanted to create many separate states within India. Bhutto once said, and I quote, "Once the back of Indian forces is broken in the east, Pakistan should occupy the whole of eastern India and make it a permanent part of East Pakistan. Kashmir should be taken at any price, even the Sikh Punjab, and turn it into Khalistan," unquote. Bhutto was hanged by another military dictator, General Zia. And General Zia, who succeeded Bhutto as the head of state, he continued that policy.
The new generation in Punjab has totally rejected Pakistan's malicious propaganda and has opposed any such move that divides people along lines of faith. Hence, Islamabad should now understand that it cannot achieve its goal of forming a separate Khalistan either through conventional war or through other conspiracies.